with 100 million mobile phones, e-commerce, you would have heard a lot of stories that companies are getting between 40% to 60% of transactions from mobile. We think that's only a beginning. We see that 3 years from now, we'll have 500 million mobile data users. And that's going to change everything the way that businesses are looking at. Whatever people are looking at from web or in other ways, will have to move mobile. We have started seeing last year mobile first companies. That means they are not looking at life as something which is starting with a baggage of saying that I'm a web-based company, right? And these are major changes we have seen in 14. I think, as rightly said in the previous talk, I think 4G and at right price can create a dramatic adoption in the coming year. I think consumer is ready to use, and people are going to find various ways in which consumer is going to use it. And we look forward to that from this people here in terms of entrepreneurship. As a venture capitalist, we are very excited about, you know, looking at this journey. So Amit, do you want to give a quick introduction about Paytm and anything that you have seen in the 2014 as a major shift?
Well, I look after the payments business at Paytm. We are trying to build a consumer payment option in India which is ubiquitous and most trusted by consumers. What does that mean? That means wherever consumer wants to transact, whether online, whether offline, he'll say, I will pay with Paytm. This is similar to what you see PayPal in US. This is similar to what you see Alipay in China, and so on and so forth. 2014 has been a milestone year for us. We launched our semi-closed wallet on January 7, 2014. And in less than 11 months of operation, we have about 18 million wallets now. So in about a couple of months, we'll have more wallet holders, Paytm wallet holders in India than the total number of credit cards put together. And we have seen massive traction on the wallet. Today we do in excess of 15 million transactions monthly on the Paytm wallet. Less than in July, we started rolling out the wallet APIs for the merchants. Obviously, there were initial questions. Why would a consumer use wallet? Why would he keep money somewhere, et cetera, when he can pay through credit card, et cetera? Some of the very, very interesting use cases which we have seen, Uber obviously is one of the latest use case. We have been able to marry the convenience with the seamless transaction part there. I was just hearing Anand. He mentioned about Wing getting a lot of accolades on best music app. Incidentally, we are the wallet providers out there, exclusive wallet providers out there. Another thing which he mentioned was build a product which is worth of your time, build a product which is worth of that scale. I think in less than 1 year, we have built a product. Nobody used to talk about wallet 1 year back. Today, everyone talks about wallets. And this is something which we have been built over a period of last 1 year.
Yeah, here regulator is also coming to grips with it. Instead of being highly reactive, now they have started becoming proactive. In fact, there was a recent article which said that for small value transactions, two-factor authentication will go away. So that again will be a major enabler. Bhakta?
Hi, my name is Bhakta. I'm one of the co-founders of EasyTap. So before I say anything about EasyTap, I'd like to repeat what I told TCM a little earlier. I'm an old guy. I was building cell phones in the early 90s. And those times, in the early 90s, people were telling that I can take my cell phone, go to a vending machine, tap, and a Coke bottle falls out. It's 20 years then, and I still can't do that, just to set expectations. So I'm the co-founder of EasyTap. I like to build things. So what we have built is a device, a small device, a cheap device, a reliable device, completely designed and manufactured in Bangalore with a simple smartphone, even a 3,000, 4,000 rupees smartphone. You can make intelligent calls. You can do your credit card transactions, but we can add a lot more value to the transaction. We make it mobile, we make it cheap. You go to the Airtel store, you can pay your bill through EasyTap device. Amazon guys shows up in front of your house delivering your product. You now have an option of paying through credit card or a debit card, any card transaction. So that's what we do. The last thing I would like to add is, looking into the future as to where transactions are going on the mobile. So I think I'd like to add what the Airtel CPO said. What we want is a very friction-free, secure payment method from our mobile. We still can't do that. And we're all trying in different ways how to make that happen.
Prashant.
Good morning, everyone. This is Prashant. I head products and engineering at PayU. So how has it been in 2014 for us? There's been three very interesting findings. So PayU started off 3 years back primarily catering to merchants' payment needs. And over time, we have solidified our presence there. And we have built enough of a product and technology stack that we can start catering to consumer payments also. What we have seen is remarkable usage of the consumer product across a wide base of merchants. So even without a captive business model, because we are a payments company, we don't have any other business line. Without having a captive revenue model, we are able to see consumers wanting to use our product to make payments on multiple categories of merchants. That's a very interesting development for us. The other thing that we are really looking forward to is the way the banking ecosystem, right? All of your banking service providers, consumer banking service providers, the way they are moving very, very aggressively into the consumer space. Being directly integrated with banks as a payment player, we are able to see this firsthand, the kind of products that they want to drive. So I would encourage all of you to watch this video by Barclays on YouTube called Barclays Ping It. That is the kind of thing that many banks in India are talking about right now. And at PayU, we are looking to launch some products in that area in the coming few months and years. So that's it for a very brief overview of what is happening at PayU in the consumer space.
Yeah, Karthik from Momo. This is the youngest company of this panel.
Yeah, we are 6 months old. And we've been out in the market for 3 months. We call Momo. I'm Karthik. Momo is a mobile payments app. We call ourselves a payments experience company where you can pay with your phone at any kind of real world outlets. So the vision is to enable payments when you eat out, shop or commute. Today you can pay at a bunch of restaurants in Bangalore with Momo. Again, the point being to give a frictionless, seamless payment experience. To do that, we push the bill from the merchants to your phone. So if you're going out to a Toit or a Prost or any of these coffee shops, you just give your mobile number to the waiter. And from then on, you will start seeing your bill on your phone real time. And whenever you want to leave, you can pay on your phone and leave. You can also split bills with friends on the app. From your contacts, you can add TCM. You can add anyone if you're going out for a dinner together. And split bills, Dutch, or edit your amounts. Ultimately, we believe that the mobile phone as a form factor enables bill presentation and checkouts very seamlessly. It also is a very secure device. It's your most personal device. You could forget your wallet, but your phone is always next to you even when you sleep. You can integrate different kinds of payment mechanisms, whether it is to work with banks or PayU to enable debit cards or credit cards, or to work with Paytm and enable a Paytm wallet on. You can enable different payment mechanisms onto the phone and finally check out very seamlessly. So that's what we do. We're live at 50 outlets right now in Bangalore, growing very fast. And yeah.
Okay. Payment is a very important enabler and infrastructure provider for more transactions to take place on mobile. So while bandwidth comes and consumption will take place, I think one of the ways it can be accelerated will also be payments. And so we are where we are, and most of you know now what all these companies are trying to do. But I also want to ask from these industry experts who are trying to solve this problem a few questions as to what we can expect in future. One thing that India doesn't have in a significant way is P2P, right? So do you see that coming in a big way? I think only with the bank connect it is possible to do, with certain things with the wallet operation. Amit, do you expect that to come in and?
So couple of things are very, very clear. I'll not like to repeat some of them, which is like, for example, net banking pages would not open on mobile and they will continue not open on mobile for some more time because that will need changes at the bank side. Credit cards, while RBI might still say that 3D secure is authentication, etc. is not needed, but the page still have to be loaded, CVV still need to be entered, and so on and so forth. So one thing at Paytm, something which we are very, very fundamentally convinced is that there has to be an alternate payment method. And only then the payment problem will be solved. It will not work through the traditional methods. The success rate will continue to go 1%, 2% higher incrementally every quarter, etc. But there is not going to be massive increase. So typically, on average, mobile web success rates, payment success rates are about 75-80%. Mobile, it is like close to about 60-65%. There are various ways how you use the denominators and the numerators out there, but that's the number. On Paytm wallet, on Paytm, our success rates are close to 99.6-99.7%. So that's a significant shift. Even when we talk about the merchants where we are integrated, at most of the merchants, which includes BookMyShow, HomeShop, Zovi, FabFurnish, HealthCard, all these online merchants, we have started to form close to about 4-6% of their total payments in less than 4 months of operation with them. So which would mean that out of the 40 banks which those guys have integrated, we'll be bigger than like 36-37 banks already. So at the consumer side, the traction is huge. Once the consumer discovers paying through wallet on these sites, then he doesn't go back to any other mode.
So do they actually hold money now? What is the average money that people keep?
Okay,
with you?
So if I can
share. That's another big question, right? Most of them are prepaid users as well. And in prepaid balances have not been very high, as you know, right? People are actually literally living on,
sure.
You know.
So what we have seen over, there is an excess of 50 crore worth of money of users, which the users have kept with us now. And this was zero in January 2014. So the number has been scaling up. Even the voluntary additions, which was earlier like 100, 150 rupees, 200 rupees earlier, have now gone up to 1200, 1500 rupees. This is average. So obviously there are more users who are depositing 3000, 5000 at one shot. And as we our acceptability on more merchants increase, we expect this number to go even higher. So people are comfortable keeping money with us. People are comfortable saving their cards with us. See, the typical user progression is he comes on you, transacts. He feels comfortable, then he saves the card because he feels this is going to have a faster checkout. And then he'll say, okay, let me put some money as well. And then the money quanta just gets increased. Today we have close to about 6 million cards saved on Paytm platform, which means roughly one out of three cards, probably one out of two cards in India, which are being used online, are already saved. These are payment tokens. Okay. Money is a payment token.
Okay.
And it is more about the user confidence in keeping more tokens with us. And that's probably the story across.
Okay.
It is not only true for Paytm, it will be true for some of the other wallets, some of the other payment companies as well. That's what I was discussing with some of the panelists before this call, that whenever the confidence in payments will increase, it will automatically benefit everyone, whether it is the merchants, whether it is the consumers, and whether it is the players like us, everyone.
Yeah, shifting gears, you know, in the acceptance side, right, Apple has launched with the NFC, right, and potentially others may also follow. Do you see that actually easing a lot of pain? Is it likely to come to India? Is two-factor authentication going to be a, you know, difficult thing for that? You know, I thought I'll just ask
sure.
both of you because you are in the acceptance infrastructure,
yeah.
Merchants representing merchants. So,
what Apple has done is they do card emulation,
yeah.
Which reduces the friction from the consumer side.
Okay.
So finally, we can actually tap the phone to make a payment, and the biometric sensor on the phone access the authentication. So having said that, so your question was specifically with the 2FA, the two-factor authentication, which...
So do you see NFC coming to India in a big way? And second is, if so, is 2FA going to be a challenge to that, in terms of slowing it down?
Yeah. So is NFC going to come to India? I have no idea. So we are working on it. Lot of customers, lot of banks or customers are asking for NFC acceptability. It is hard to predict, at least I don't know when NFC will become big. We have just started on the chip card journey exactly 1 year ago. December 1st of last year was when chip cards became mandatory. So having said that, one thing I've seen in India is because of the huge consumer base, things can take off very quickly, like the mobile phones. So at least till last year, from what I understand, we were adding 100 million subs every year. It is like adding 1 euro every year. So the trajectory could be very steep. And the second question is the 2FA, the two-factor authentication. As some of you might have read yesterday, I think, RBI is releasing 1FA directive soon. That means for transactions below a floor limit, I can just swipe my card and keep going. So someday, my favorite use case is still I use lot of autos in Bangalore quite a bit. I still hope someday I can just tap the auto meter and walk out, right?
Okay.
So it might come. So the 1FA might solve the problem, but NFC, it's hard to predict.
Karthik?
NFC, I just have one thought. So we deal with a lot of merchants, and whenever we ask merchant to buy additional hardware, we've always found that merchants have a certain sense of inhibition or there's a resistance whenever I ask them to buy additional hardware. But that said, make a cheap one. Yeah, I wish we could work together to make a cheap one. And someone with deep pockets like Google Wallet should go around and collaborate with a MasterCard and give out 200,000 NFC readers to all the merchants and then wait for the takeoff to happen. So that has to happen in terms of NFC to take off. But that said, most of 40% of our user base currently has NFC capability on their phones of the users of Momo. And when we look at the data, we realize that if people are ready to pay seamlessly on their phones, a tap might not be something which will restrict them. So if the opportunity was available, it would happen. But hardware requirement at the merchant side is the resistance. And what we have done consciously is to eliminate hardware as much as possible. To enable payments on Momo at the merchant place, we require zero hardware. We integrate with their billing software. So that makes it seamless for the merchant to work with us.
Okay. So Prashant, in PayU, one of the things that as a gateway provider, and you also heard that in online it is possibly 80%, when mobile it is about 60-65%. Anand also saying that infrastructure could actually be an issue. So are you seeing that this can be increased? Because in payment, one of the important things is that non-repudiation, very quick transaction closure, right? And in real life, many of us don't know that when a card is swiped, in 15 seconds or less, you get an approval in the physical world. That is even after the transaction has gone all the way back to, let's say, a server sitting in US and then coming back, right? And so what do you see as trend going forward? And what are you guys working on that front?
So that's actually very central to us, right? The what Amit was saying about why people would start using wallets more and more. So one of the things that we have figured out is the refund experience is very, very critical in getting someone to use their stored value, whether it's a wallet or some other means of stored value, more than a traditional form of payment. In a traditional form of payment these days, it takes a minimum of 3 to 4 days to get your money back. Now, if I can, with PayU, again, we have that advantage of having very close ties with the banks, but if we can figure out a faster refund experience and route it to a stored value, we are killing 2-3 birds with that stone, right? One is, for subsequent transactions, you don't need 2FA, because we are taking care of the risk and security on the wallet ourselves or in the stored value ourselves. And with the refund, happening faster, generally the adoption of this stored value will increase. This means a lot of engineering work on the back end with the banks and also sometimes with the merchants, right? So there are use cases. Let's take ClearTrip, for instance, or any other, Book My Show, right?
So you have these dynamically priced inventory, right, and with merchants like this. They need to know very, very quickly what the status of the transaction is. If your mobile phone network is slow, for whatever reason, you cannot hold a customer to penalty because the mobile network is slow. So we invest a lot of time and effort into server-to-server integrations with banks and merchants to ensure that even if the app or the browser does not get redirected back to the merchant knows and the merchant can inform the customer through some other, you know, ways or means. And this set of ties with the merchants and banks is very, very interesting and necessary. So even if you look at Apple Pay, the product is successful because, like you said, they've somehow subsidized that hardware at nearly, you know, dozens of hundreds of thousands of merchants, right? That is very, very critical. And that's where banks, having a closer relationship with banks can sometimes help. You are closer to Master, you're closer to Visa, you can enable all of those things a little better.